Google dominates the browser market with Chrome. Most of you will use it on at least one of your devices. And so the shocking new warnings about Chrome's creepy new tracking should give you serious reason for concern. It might be time for you to quit. The headlines this week have been dominated by Apple's iOS 14.5. Finally, we have the long-awaited crackdown on Facebook-style tracking. But while we've been distracted by Tim Cook versus Mark Zuckerberg, Google has quietly been testing its own new tracking on millions of unsuspecting Chrome users. But this secretive update is now coming under intense fire, with blocks and potential blocks, and regulatory concerns. Part of the wider privacy backlash, fueled by Apple and others, has been a war on the cookie. The digital footprints you leave as you use the internet recognize you as you return to familiar sites but also track your activity, enabling shadowy data brokers to feed your profile to algorithms that pull your strings. Google plans to banish cookies from Chrome, moving towards what it calls a privacy-first web. Cookies have eroded user trust, Google says, confirming that it does not plan to replace these with alternate identifiers to track individuals as they browse across the web. But the danger for Chrome users is that the first privacy-preserving solution to be launched by Google is arguably little better, and could even be worse. I've discussed FLoC before and its impact on Apple users. But the issue is much wider. Chrome's federated learning of cohorts algorithmically groups users by common traits, browsing behaviors, and inferred characteristics. Each cohort of 1,000 plus users has a unique identifier, which is presented to each website a cohort member visits. The cohort ID does not detail the common traits that define the group, it's for the ad industry to work this out. Advertisers don't need to track individual consumers across the web to get the performance benefits of digital advertising, Google says, assuring it can hide individuals within large crowds of people with common interests. But however good FLoC might be in isolation and under laboratory conditions, when it's deployed in combination with other technologies across a vast digital ad industry with billions of dollars at stake, the potential for abuse is huge. FLoC has been roundly criticized for being tracking, just by another name. FLoC is bad for privacy, privacy first DuckDuckGo warns. It puts you in a group based on your browsing history, any website can get that group FLoC ID to target and fingerprint you. It's like walking into a store where they already know all about you. What DuckDuckGo means is that the enterprising digital ad industry, and the shadowy data brokers behind the scenes, can combine a FLoC ID with other data, such as your IP address, which means you can continue to be tracked easily as an individual.